Greetings, and welcome to the first version of our integrated circular city system in virtual reality. I'm presently in Unreal Engine 4. This is a miniaturized version of the city, and at real-world scale, this city is approximately 2 kilometers in diameter. Now, this is a concentric circular city, as opposed to a circular city with overlapping circulars. This is just one of many possible city configurations. All of the content you see here is available via our GitHub page, which you can access through the Auravana Project's website at auravana.com. That's auravana.com. The first area of this circular city arrangement I would like to point out is the city's center, its central access point. Here in the center of one of these circular cities, you may find medical care, conference centers, exhibition and art centers, and a whole host of other spaces where social interaction occurs. This central area may also be a transportation hub if the city includes a mass rapid transportation system. Note that if medical facilities are placed in the central hub here, then you are never further away from receiving medical care than if you were in the same belt in another sector of the city, which is an important consideration for an active and playful population. And of course, under other city configurations, the central area may not have any buildings, but instead it may be a garden for common gathering and natural beauty. The next area we come to is one of the water management circulars, including fountains and pools. I've modeled out one of these pool segments and duplicated it around the city 7 times. Moving out from the central area, this configuration has permacultural and aquacultural walking gardens and parks. These are beautiful landscapes organized for food cultivation and aesthetic relaxation. As you walk through them, fresh food is available seasonally for gathering and harvest. There is also space in this circular ring for playing and contemplation. The next circular belt out is mostly composed of buildings used for the completion of work relevant to the continuity of the entire city system. It is more commonly known as the Inter-System Operations Circular. These buildings house access hubs, maintenance and operations facilities, as well as research and production spaces. Here, we primarily complete work which updates and cycles services, materials, and technologies through the city. All belts are multifunctional, and so within these buildings, there are also many common access spaces for a wide variety of technical and creativity-oriented activities. Now, as we move away from the inter-system habitat service belt, we come to the recreational area, which has courts, gyms, and all of the games and recreational activities that people require, amongst beautiful terrain and landscaping. This belt has art centers, theaters, courts, indoor pools, and natural outdoor swimming ponds, and various spaces for practice and entertainment. There may also be dining facilities here and other amenities. As we move outward again, we come to the low-density dwelling and housing area, where there are winding streams, ponds, waterfalls, and lovely gardens throughout, giving each dwelling a view of beauty and a feeling of being at restorative peace with the world. The residential area of the city continues the idea of coexisting harmoniously with nature. All of the houses are similar in their modern rounded design, but at the same time are very different. Their uniqueness is a reflection of the owner's personality and desired functioning of the home. The architectural elements of all dwellings are flexible and coherently arranged to best serve individual preference. The features of all dwellings in the city are selected by the occupants themselves. In between every home are natural barriers like bushes and trees, isolating one from another with lush landscaping. So people who prefer to live in houses and maintain gardens may prefer to live in this area. Here, there are 8 dwellings down each side of the low density segment's radial pathways, making 16 dwellings per pathway. There are 3 pathways per primary radial sector, making 48 low density dwellings per primary radial sector. And there are 8 primary radial sectors for a total of 384 low density dwellings. The next belt we come to primarily functions for high-density dwelling. Its dwellings are for those who prefer apartments. The reason some people may want to live in an apartment is because the apartment buildings themselves have a large number of services built into the tower, providing immediate and close access for those who might want that sort of dwelling placement. People who choose to live in apartments may prefer a more socially dense dwelling arrangement. These dwellings are also above the ground, and so they provide beautiful views of the city and surrounding natural environment. Secondarily, this belt maintains energy production systems, as well as lovely gardens and relaxed common gathering areas. Here, there are 28 apartments per building. There are 3 apartment buildings per primary radial sector, making 84 high-density dwellings per primary radial sector. And there are 8 primary radial sectors for a total of 672 high-density dwellings. Therefore, in total, there are 1,056 dwellings. If each dwelling were to contain 1 to 4 people, then the population density for the city, given only the number of dwellings present here, is anywhere from 1,056 to 4,224, with 4 people per dwelling. Passing out of the high-density dwelling belt on our way to the outer ring of the city, we come to the greenhouse cultivation belt in between 2 water channels. On this belt, we organically grow a wide variety of plant and insect species, both outdoor and inside greenhouses. Here, a beautiful walking and bicycling path encircles the belt. When looking at the water channels, consider for a moment the wisdom of our ancestors in their choice to develop their living spaces around a water source. Here, the waterways provide for water storage, harvesting, irrigation, and purification. On the water channels, there are water harvesting technologies, including solar distillation units. These evaporative condensation systems are one means by which the city creates clean drinking water. And more than likely, at least one channel is always available for swimming. Although not visible here, one might imagine that just beyond the final waterway is a circular zone constructed as a geomorphic vegetation barrier. It is designed to prevent ecological disruption to the inner city and purify environmental runoff from the next belt outward. The vegetation selected for this natural barrier will have a second purpose. It will be used for harvesting into food, textiles, and many other useful materials. In this configuration, the outer perimeter ring is in part a circular farm, a holistically planned grazing system also known by the name circular symbiotic cultivation, regenerative agriculture, rotational grazing, and syntropy farming. It is a biomimicry process that mirrors what occurs in nature. Here, the farming follows natural ecological cycles. This circular area is primarily a combination of pasture and orchard land that we move different animals through in a particular order in order to mimic natural cycles, which builds our soil base and provides food and other materials. In this area, there's grass between trees, and often, when left unchecked, the grass will grow up and choke out the trees, same with shrubs. Modern society generally prevents this consequence by using a lawnmower, but nature provides an alternative. Imagine running a number of different organisms around this circular ringed area. We send cattle through the orchard and let them mow down all the grass. And as they go, the cattle fertilize the trees. They deposit their waste and then trample it into the ground to create fertile, carbon-rich soil. A few days after the cattle, we send the goats, who eat the shrubbery that the cattle wouldn't necessarily eat. The goats also climb up and prune the bottom 6 feet of the trees. They also fertilize. Pigs are run through as leftover waste consumers. Then we send through the chickens in a mobile chicken coop. The chickens also fertilize the soil and eat all the bugs that hatch from the manure of the first 2 ruminants that went through. Chickens come in after the pigs have dug up big clumps of grass. They quote unquote clean out the area and fertilize with their high nitrogen manure. So at the least, we intentionally run 4 different animal species through this area, and as a result, we get multiple cultivations, we build up our soil base, and we have the opportunity to play a role in the well-being of other symbiotic species while giving ourselves a picturesque environment to enjoy in a variety of fashions. Now, the animals I have mentioned here are not necessarily the animals that will be selected in any given city configuration. The selected animals will depend upon geographic location and the culture of the city's inhabitants. Among the circular farm, this ring may also be used for recreational activities such as biking, golfing, hiking, and riding. Areas herein may be set aside for renewable, clean sources of energy such as wind, solar, heat concentrating systems, geothermal, and others. There may also be large activity domes positioned around this ring, if that is what the population of a particular city desires. Further, there could be low-rise apartment-type structures close to the outer edge for people who prefer apartments but would like a more outdoorsy type of living, close to where the city returns to wild nature. And finally, this outer perimeter could be considered another natural barrier designed to prevent ecological disruption to the inner city. Beyond the outer belt, we allow the environment to return to nature while still caretaking our total habitat. When a city reaches its planned size, we stop and mostly let nature return to its wild state between this and the next city. There will still, of course, be some recreational, mining, and manufacturing facilities between cities. Yet, there is no urban sprawl. Out in nature, we can wild food forage and relearn some of the survival skills of our ancestors. In concern to transportation, these cities generally contain 2 to 4 primary transportation gateways, in other words, entrances and exits. Few transportation gateways are needed for the city because of its efficient design. Here, transportation between cities utilizes a mass rapid rail transportation system. Transportation within this walking garden city is shared between specialized electric motor vehicles and self-powered vehicles, such as bicycles. Further, all of these forms of transport are emissions-free. The design of these cities removes the need for each individual or family to have a personal automobile. Of course, mostly these cities are designed for walking. Some cities, however, are large enough to necessitate autonomous transveyors and/or an MRT system, that stands for Mass Rapid Transportation System, within their limits. I would like to leave you with one final thought. With a population of over 7 billion people on the planet, it is essential for us to merge our knowledge of nature with a fulfillment orientation that can guide the things we do and the cities we create.